Please join in singing number 449 in Breaking Bread, Amazing Grace, number 449.
Thank you. second reading ordinance. I know this is a good one because my mom shows this to my dad. God is with us. Who can be against us? Since he did not spare his own son, but gave him up for the sake of all of us, then can we not expect that with him, he will freely give us all his gifts? Who can bring any accusation against those that God has chosen? When God grants saving grace, who can condemn? We are not sure, are we not sure that it is Jesus Christ who died? Yes and more. He was raised from the dead and is at God's right hand, and who is advocate for us? Can anything cut us from the love of Christ? Can hardships or distress, persecution, lack of food, clothing, or threats of violence? No. We come through all these things triumphantly victorious by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, so is my mom. Neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nothing already in existence, and nothing still to come, nor any power, nor the heights or depths, nor any created thing will be able to come between us and the love of God. Look to us, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Still sleeping, but she she woke up and she smiled and she was assisted by her granddaughter to help her sit up. And as I entered the room, I don't know Spanish. So our family helped me to help to translate, and we got to talk. And I just really was incredibly, just simply incredible presence of a wonderful, absolutely wonderful lady. She had such a good sense of humor, even during her state, that she was not happy to know that her family shared that she was 93 years old. But from meeting with Anna and her family, looking over the many family pictures, especially her wedding photo, her and her late husband, her godfather, I truly was in the presence of a wonderful, incredible lady of faith, of conviction, brilliance, humor, and a deep sense of love. That love that extended to her family, and those whom she invited into her life and her family. So I want to say thank you for allowing me to experience just a small tip of that. I'd also had the opportunity of talking to her children last week and learning also that her story with her husband exemplifies that American dream. Born in Paraguay, she was an aspiring poet and singer, but she caught the eye of a young gentleman, Adolfo. I could see why from her loving photo would caught her, but caught his eye. After a couple years, they would reconnect and would blossom into a romance and marriage for 54 years. Eventually, Adolfo would eventually earn his doctorate in medicine. And the two of them, after a roundabout way, would find their way here in Cleveland, Ohio, where they could settle down in this marriage and make this marriage their home. For Anna, she was a typical and in many ways a wonderful stay-at-home wife and mother, raising five children. But her life, as we know, would endure with many hardships. First of all, losing her son, and dealing with difficulties of life that we cannot speak here today, and also having to share with caring for her husband, who had passed away 13 years ago. These experiences, while many would cause them to challenge the love and question their faith, it did not for her. We hear in our second reading from St. Paul how Paul reminds us that if we believe in God, that if we know this, that God is for us, who can be against us? And that neither life or death, angels, demons, the past, the present, nor the future things can never separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. It is this perseverance in our faith that is a hallmark of Christians, because Christ never promises that life is easy. He never promises that faith in Him will equate to an easy life on earth. But He does promise us that for those who remain faithful to Him, that there is an eternal reward for us in heaven. Our gospel today reminds us of this, from Matthew's gospel, that those who place His yoke upon our shoulders, that no matter what, He will give us rest. And I think those words that Jesus would have said to him, to all of us, and most especially to Anna today, come to me, all you labor and burden, and I will give you rest. This rest is really more of a peace of mind and peace of heart. That those who persevere on this earth in faith and love are given an eternal reward with them in heaven. And that no matter the hardships of life that we endure, God will give us true peace and a true sense of hope in Him. And that eternal life in Him is given as a gift to all of us. And that for us to persevere in this faith, or believe in that eternal promise with God, that when we come to the end of our life, if we truly love God and love our brothers and sisters around us, then we are given that eternal rescue, that eternal peace. And that experience in heaven, in many ways, is a hallmark of Christians. And that any tears of sadness and doubt should often return to tears of joy. Because we can believe and hope that Adam has gone where we hope to go. That she is now in heaven with all the angels and saints, and all those marked with the sign of faith forever and ever. That all of them are given eternal peace with God forever and ever. In many ways, as I said, she is gone where we hope to go. But we can believe that she is with her husband, all the saints, the Son, and all those marked with the sign of faith. Again, I just extend my condolences to all of you here today. Please know about our prayers. We stand and offer our prayers of petition before we turn out and offer our prayers of petition. In baptism, Adam, receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Adam is nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Friends and members of our family have gone before us away to the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. In a special way, we remember the deceased members of Anna's family, her husband and her son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who trust in the Lord and not sleep in the Lord, we refresh your peace to all those whose faith is known to you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the family and friends of Anna who seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel the darkness that comes from grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for all of us assembled here in faith and confidence as we pray for our Savior, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all the prayers which we hold in the silence of our hearts that we bring here to the dead. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of your Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them an everlasting place in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Please join in singing number 534, Prayer for St. Francis, number 534.
Oh.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the mighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings for the salvation of your servant Anna, we beseech you, mercy that she, and not God your Son, be a loving Savior, may find him a merciful judge through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, to Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned. Those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. And gained through a faithful word, a life is changed, not ended. This earthly dwelling turns to dust, eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and enemies, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we see him of your glory, as without him, we have hope.
Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil. Pray you have peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we will always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we have the blessed hope at the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but the faith of your church. Gracious God, have peace, and you can support us with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other this night.
Please join in singing number 440, On Eagle's Wings, number 440.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son loved us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Anna may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. And one day we shall joyfully greet her again. The love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thou art with 430.